What's up, guys? It's Chris, and welcome back to My Corvette Life. Today is delivery day. The Callaway should be arriving momentarily on the truck. So let's wait and see when it shows up. Okay, here we go. Family reacting to the Callaway. There it is. What do you think?
What happened?
What happened? It's dirty.
It's dirty? Yeah.
Yeah, Daddy's got to clean it all up.
Oh no, I stay here.
Yeah? Yeah, it's going to take me a while though.
You're going to help Daddy with it, aren't you?
Yeah. Does it look similar to the other car that I had?
Balls.
Oh, she's done with the Corvette. She wants her balls.
Man, this is cool.
It's a red Corvette, just like the one I had.
What do you think?
I think it's pretty cool. It's definitely going to need some work. Mm-hmm. But, I mean, I'm excited to see you clean the engine.
I can't find it.
When you clean those engines, it's amazing.
Balls.
Yeah, I know.
I don't know where your ball is. We're concentrating on the car right now.
No.
What?
I think it's cool. It kind of... It looks like a Corvette, but it also doesn't look like a Corvette. Like, it's very different than the one you had. Mm-hmm. How many years difference is there?
Look,
2 years difference.
And Jack wake up.
Yeah, Jack and Mickey are woke up. But just considering it's only 2 years, you can definitely see that the Callaway part is what makes it so different, I would imagine, because I can't imagine the car was that different base model.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Daddy, what's that?
It looks good. It looks like you're going to have your hands full.
All right. Well, the Callaway is home, so let's go ahead and do a walk around and I'll show you guys everything that's in store. So as you guys can probably tell as I walk around the car is absolutely filthy. It actually was a lot dirtier than it is here. The previous owner actually did give it a light sponge bath before it left his house. I'm going to be washing everything, obviously. As soon as it's clean... then we can actually dig in and see what all is wrong with the car. Just on the surface, every little spot is just absolutely filthy. But you can see we got the Callaway aero body. This thing is so awesome. The front bumper does need some repairs. It's got a crack right there. Needs a full repaint on the bumper. I'm going to see what I can do about the rest of the car. I think once I get it clean, I think we can do a paint correction on it. And 99% of what I can see visually should be okay. The only thing that I am concerned about is this. You might have seen this when the car was on the truck, but... there was a can of something in the rafters that leaked and leaked down the whole side of this car, as well as his Viper that you may have seen parked underneath this car. But it is kind of soft to the touch, so I'm wondering if I can use maybe a steam cleaner and see what I can do about gently getting that off and see if it actually deteriorated the paint at all. If so, we might need to repaint this. But like I said, don't know until we get it all clean. Heart of the beast right here. Obviously, everything is filthy, but two intercoolers on top. Callaway twin turbo. When these things are spotless and nice and clean, this thing is beautiful. It's nice, polished aluminum. It's currently got a lot of oxidation on here. I mean, it's just dusty and filthy. it needs to be completely disassembled, cleaned, repolished, the whole nine yards. These tires are probably close to 20 years old. You can see there. I mean, obviously, the car has been sitting on a lift for 15 years. They were probably on the car even before that, I'm sure. So that's going to be a somewhat of a big expense, probably about $1,200 for a full set of tires. Brakes are going to have to be changed out. Going to remove the calipers as well. Going to have those rebuilt. Let's walk around to the other side here. Other than that, I'm going to be taking the entire top end completely apart. Take the injectors out, get those serviced. Going to just be going through the whole thing, replacing a lot of known parts that need to be replaced. Probably get a new alternator. It's got some corrosion on it. If they're cheap enough, might as well. The radiator is kind of an unknown. It currently doesn't have any fluid in it. As far as I'm told, I haven't checked myself yet. But no idea what condition the radiator is in. But if we do need a radiator, my friends over at DeWitt's should be helping us out there. Battery is nice and brand new. So thank you to the previous owner for doing that for me. Kind of needed a new battery in the car to get this thing pushed on the truck. You might see this weird sheen in the windshield. I was told that this car had a special option. It was like it's called like a coolant or something. I don't know a whole lot about it. I haven't done enough research in it, but it's got like this layer in the glass that's supposed to reflect heat or something. You can see right here where it doesn't. Supposedly that is for putting your radar right there, because the radar won't work up here because of the layer in the glass. Again, I don't know a whole lot about that. I haven't done my research on that yet. I was just told about that yesterday, I think. What else? Interior looks to be in pretty decent shape. Again, it's filthy. Everything needs to be cleaned. I'm probably going to remove the seats and just do a thorough cleaning. The back needs some carpet. It's missing some carpet back there. This car does have a harness bar. I haven't decided what I'm going to do with that yet. I'm probably going to be returning this car mostly back to stock form. Maybe leaving some of the stuff, but we'll see when we get going. Another thing you may have noticed, we're missing something right here. Target top is missing off this car. So that obviously played a part of the purchase of the car. If you guys know or have a used C4 top, I think it has to be an 89 through 96 top because some of the latches changed in 89. If you have an 89 to 96 clear top that you're willing to get rid of, or maybe you have an extra one or something, let me know. I've been looking for a used one for several months now and haven't come across one. Seems like before I was looking for one, I would see one pop up all the time. And now that I'm looking for one, I can't find one. So a new one is roughly $1,500 shipped to my house. So I'm hoping not to spend quite that much. But if I have to, I will. I just don't want to. Wheels look to be in decent condition. If you guys didn't know, these are magnesium, specifically for the Callaways, made by Dymag. So yeah, they are supposedly super light. I don't know exactly how much they weigh. I remember on my 88 Corvette, the wheels were ridiculously heavy. So I'm interested to see how these compare. I'll get it up on a lift here soon and figure that out. But as soon as I get these things cleaned up, I'll see what kind of condition they really are in. And if I need to get them refinished, I will. The rear bumper looks to be in really good condition, so that's really good. I did notice the driver's side taillight. The like gasket that goes around the taillight lens needs to be replaced. It's a little loose right there, but hopefully those are available from Callaway. I know these lenses are. These lenses are $500 each. So good thing those things are in good condition. You can see it says Callaway right there. I've already got my old license plate on there just for looks for now. The car's not actually registered yet. Emblems will need to be replaced. There we go. Inside there, we're going to be taking this all apart, inspecting the fuel tank, replacing the fuel filter, fuel pump, all of that stuff. So that's to come. Obviously, this is all filthy. That door does have glass. It's just rolled down right now. Glass seems to be in good shape. Obviously, this is filthy here. There was a big glob of something on the windshield here. It looks like he got most of it off. I'll be going through and cleaning all of that. And then obviously this is the big thing. We're gonna be tearing this thing down to nothing, replacing a lot of stuff here, cleaning everything, because everything is filthy and old and who knows what I'll find in there. Suspension, it does have the magnetic shocks. Bilsteins does have stainless steel braided brake lines, which is good. Otherwise, I was going to replace those. Like I said, brakes, I'll be replacing the brakes. What else? You know, it's really just a lot to go through until I start taking it apart. Who knows what I'll find? Some of you very keen-eyed viewers may have noticed that this car has nitrous injection plate right here. We got the solenoids down here. I will be removing the nitrous system off this car. It really doesn't need it. Nobody's gonna be racing this car anymore. Obviously, the newer cars are much faster and that's what everybody races. So this is more of a collector car now. So gonna be returning it mostly back to stock. So I did register this car with Callaway yesterday. Reeves Callaway actually contacted me. He's gonna be sending me all of the records that they have on this car. It has quite a few records, he says, so we'll see what is on those records and I'll let you guys know. There were quite a few modifications done to this car. Supposedly, I know the exhaust system has been changed out. We got the nitrous injection, harness bar. I think it's got 96 Grand Sport brakes on it. It's got some cross-drilled rotors. Obviously, those are all going to be changing. But lot to dig into. This is just kind of just brushing the surface, really. I really just got to dive into this thing one end at a time and just go through the entire car. It's going to be a long process. I hope you guys will stick with me on this journey. This is going to be a lot of fun. I was just thinking the other day, these cars are so rare. They only made 497 Callaway twin turbos from 87 to 91. So if you think about that, I mean, let's say if each one of those cars has an average of three owners, maybe even four, we're talking about maybe around 2,000 people in the world have ever owned one of these in their entire existence. So that rarity alone is really one of the driving factors that made me purchase this car, because when I got my 88, I was one of the very few people who was doing C4 content on YouTube. And then right after I bought my car, a bunch of other YouTubers started buying C4s. And it kind of, I mean, I don't know if I sparked that interest or not, but it kind of, I was kind of bummed about it. And then after, or when I was about to sell the car, a couple of YouTubers bought C4 ZR1s. So I was kind of, not, I know a lot of you wanted me to get a ZR1 and thought I was going to get a ZR1, but since other people are doing that, I just, that wasn't for me. But a Callaway Twin Turbo? Nobody is doing a Callaway Twin Turbo, and I don't think anybody probably ever will. But we'll see. We'll see after this. They're so rare that maybe only one or two a year even go up for sale. This one really even wasn't for sale. I just so happened to get an email from the owner who saw my video about the fake Callaway, and he reached out to me. So in a way, I kind of almost feel like the car found me. So it's a really interesting story how all of it happened, but it's here now. And now it's my obligation to bring this thing back to its former glory. Anyways, I hope you guys are as excited for this project as I am. I'm ready to go. So smash that like button. Really helps out the channel. If you're not already subscribed, please hit that subscribe button below. We've got so much more content to cover. We'll see you guys later. Take care.